Andrew McCart, IFL TV in association with MTK Global. I'm here in Frisco, Texas. With me, I've got, and I've been interviewing heavyweights all week out in Vegas. I've got another one, Chantel Winters. Tough opponent in Joseph Parker this Saturday night. You've got a smile on your face. You must be excited.
Oh, man, I'm extremely blessed. I'm highly favored, man. I thank God every day for this opportunity. It's just a blessing, man, for me to be brought from the back to the forefront to put my God-given abilities on display come Saturday night.
What can we expect from you on Saturday night? I mean, you're a clear underdog, but the heavyweight division, we've seen underdogs go at it. We've seen Andy Ruiz beat Joshua. We've seen Tyson Fury, who was a slight underdog against Wilder, go out and pull off the win. We're going to see Lightning strike three times this Saturday?
Well, Lightning strike, I can kind of say that because I got some speed. But what to expect, man, you can expect for me to go out there and put it all on the line. I'm extremely confident. I'm prepared. I'm ready for whatever Joseph Parker brings to the table. And I can't wait to put my God-given ability on display come Saturday night.
Can you stop Joseph Parker to make a huge statement in the heavyweight division?
Again, this is heavyweight boxing. Anybody that gets hit clean and heavyweight in the heavyweight division can be affected. History has showed us that. So the thing is, whether he's looking for my power or I'm looking for him, the thing is, you know, he's going to come in wanting to impose his size, his strength, his height, and everything. And I have to give him something to think about to change his mind, and I'm prepared to do that.
What does a win against Joseph Parker do for your career? Does that propel you up there to where the sort of Povetkins, the Michael Hunters, to these type of guys, and obviously the bigger fights going forward?
Well, what a win does for me is it further cements, you know, my legacy. This is all about legacy. I'm not supposed to be here. Nobody knows me. They clown the fight on social media. And a lot of people, you know, who is this guy, this, that, and the third? And a win over Joseph Parker, it just announces to the heavyweight division that I'm here to stay and that I do mean business.
I want to, since you are a heavyweight, there was a huge heavyweight fight this past Saturday, Wilder versus Fury. Were you as surprised as everyone else the way Fury approached that fight?
No. Fury, by him gaining the extra weight, he let it be known the way that he was planning on fighting. He came forward, he wanted to fight Deontay Wilder. He wasn't necessarily trying to box. And you gotta tip your hat off to him. He's a world champion now. He was the lineal champion, and I mean, you got to tip your hat off to Tyson Fury. Tyson Fury is a great fighter.
In terms of like what's next for Tyson Fury, would you want to see the third fight with Wilder, or you want to see him become undisputed? We'll have the undisputed fight against Anthony Joshua. I'm not selfish as us in British, because we've got all the, it's more for us rather than Americans, but as a heavyweight, you must be excited for one of these fights.
To be honest with you, I can't say like which one I want. I'm just a fan of the sport. Like when I'm not boxing, I'm a fan of boxing. I'm a sports fanatic, period. Whether it's boxing, swimming, football, basketball, soccer, baseball, whatever, it doesn't matter. I'm just a sports guy. So if he fought Deontay Wilder again, that would be awesome. If he fought Joshua, that would be awesome. So you can't lose as a boxing fan, you know, with either one of those fights.
I'll put you on the spot then. Who wins, Joshua, Fury?
That's going to be tough. It's hard for me to predict.
I'm going to put a gun to your head. You have to predict.
I think whoever can impose their will as far as sticking to the game plan, whoever has the best game plan and sticks to it will end up getting their hand raised.
You're not going to give me a name, are you?
It's just hard to predict those type of things because just like in my fight, you know, I could say, anybody could say, well, Joseph Parker's fought this guy, he's fought that guy, and on this level, he's proven. But we don't know who he is in front of Chandel Winters. You know, so at the end of the day, Tyson Fury could have came off of one of his best victories, and we don't know the Tyson Fury that's going to show up in front of Anthony Joshua or the Anthony Joshua that's going to show up in front of Tyson Fury. So those matchups are intriguing. You can have an opinion, But I just think it's going to be a matter of game plan and who executes. Anthony Joshua had a brilliant game plan against Ruiz, and he didn't just go in there trying to think about it. And he had a game plan, and we saw that work. So it's a matter, I believe, of who has the better game plan and sticks to the game plan.
Finally, before I let you go, what can us as fans, what can we expect from you on Saturday night against Joseph Parker?
You can expect somebody to come in and put it all on the line. You can expect for me to go forward, sometimes counter-punching, sometimes leading. Really, it's whatever he want to do.
Shondell, thanks for this for IFL TV, brother. I really appreciate your time, and good luck Saturday night, man.
Yes, sir. IFL TV, man, the best.
You know. Thanks very much, champ. Yes, sir.